used carts. Contrary to some, like I said, like Rob, used carts are easier to find at reasonable prices during the winter months. Now, Rob's just against, you know, used carts pretty much any time unless it's your only option. But I'm not. And so I guess everybody, you know, has their opinions. There's probably not a wrong or right to it. It's just I believe that if that's how you can get in and it gets you in faster, then by all means, get it going. Get it done. Let's go. Giddy up. So used carts. Let me run through some of these things about used carts. Contrary to some, you want to find, if you look in the winter months, the fall, you know, late fall, winter, you will find some screaming good deals. Best places to find them? Craigslist. I'm sure you've all heard of Craigslist.org. A lot of people go to .com, but it's .org. And there's another website. Because Craigslist may not have any in your local area, and you don't want to have to go city to city and pull up a new Craigslist and, okay, and do a search. There's a website called Crazedlist, C-R-A-Z-E-D-L-I-S-T, and that is a excellent spot to find multiple spots. Are multiple cities Craigslist ads, and you can pick the cities you want, or you can pick the whole country if you want. Of course, that'd be a big search, but you could do it however you wanted and find it. We also have a used cart page. We update almost daily as we get carts and carts are sold. We update it immediately at learnhotdogs.com. So go to the blog, learnhotdogs.com. On the top, you'll see a menu items, and one of them says used carts. Click on it. There's used carts there, and if it may help you out. There's not, you know, hundreds of carts, but Craigslist, Crazedlist, learnhotdogs.com. There's lots of places to look for used carts. That's just three right off the top of my head. What's a good price? A good price is what you're willing to pay, and you will find that carts hold their value. I've seen carts on Craigslist for $3,000 that are 12 years old. And you go, my gosh, I can buy a new cart for $500 more. Well, yeah, you can. Do you have $500 more? Well, if you don't, then you can buy this one. And that's how people look at it. And there's always a need. There's always a need. And I've had some people call, and let me go ahead and pop this idea, is people call me and go, well, why is there, if this business is so good, why is there used carts? And that's like saying, well, if houses are so good to live in, why is there houses for sale? Well, it's because not everybody is cut out for this. Some people buy carts they can't use. Some people buy it and go, you know, I don't like this at all. This is horrible. Or they didn't do their due diligence, or they didn't make the right decisions, or they didn't budget correctly. There's a blue million reasons why people sell these. It's like you can find right now 2012 model Cadillacs for sale. And you go, well, what's wrong with Cadillac then? Why would there anybody be selling them? If your cars are that good, why would you be selling that? Well, it's just a numbers game. There are people that buy a Cadillac and find out, you know, I don't like it. It's just too comfortable. And they sell it, or they didn't like the color, or whatever, or they found something better and bigger and better and newer and, you know, keeping up with the Joneses deal. So don't ever wonder about that. Just move on. You can find a good price. A good price, I have people call me and they go, Ben, can you look at this ad and tell me if it's a good price? It's what you're willing to pay. I mean, that's what it comes down to. And if you've been looking a while and you want to get started now and you got an event coming up this Thursday and blah, 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 you may need to go ahead and buy it. Then it's a good price. And the nice part is, even if you get ripped, I told a guy recently out in Colorado, I told him, I said, listen, he goes, I just don't want to make sure I don't get ripped off. I know the car to pass inspection. I gave the schematics to my health inspector, blah, blah, blah. But I think he's wanting too much for it. And I'm going, okay, well, you can either look for another hot dog cart for two more weeks, and that's 2 weeks you couldn't be serving. You could have been making money. And how long is it going to take to pay for itself? You've already got gigs lined up. You've already got a location. You've already made sure that the cart is going to get a pre-approved, you know, approved by your health inspector because you gave him schematics to this used cart. And that's something else we'll touch on here in just a second. But why would you wait? And so I'm not trying to push you into it. I don't want you to rush into it. But I'm saying once you've done all your due diligence, and the only thing holding you up is the price, as far as you think it's not a good deal, well, if it delays you getting into the business and making money, then it's a bad way to do it. Always see the cart in person, period. Never buy it over the phone. Never buy it. And I'm talking used carts, but never believe their website stuff. You know, their Craigslist ad. You want to go see that cart in person. You may get there and go, well, the whole back end's wrecked out of it. And I tried to get a picture to load, but Craigslist only let me load four, and I only was able to load those four good pictures. That bad picture, I wasn't able to load. Well, duh. Always go in person and make sure it's working, too. There's carts out there. We've got some companies. I know two companies right now today that knock off our cart. They knock it off. They build it, okay? And they use inferior stuff, and one of them's okay. They do a decent job. The other one just knocks it off completely. He's fairly new in business, started this year. And I don't care. That doesn't bother me. What bothers me is he's marketing it as a cart, as a good cart, and it's crap. It's completely crap. Using galvanized pipes for his water system and his gas lines. That won't even pass in most states. Health inspector get there and go, what? Your gas lines are galvanized? We got rid of that in the 70s. You can't do that. You know, and some states don't care, but I'm giving you an idea. These are things you want to look at. You want to look at what it's made of. You want to go see it, touch it, feel it, and go, aha, that's a good cart. And be able to make those decisions. I teach you in my book, but I teach to always carry a propane tank with you. That way, if you get there and they go, well, I'd let you fire it up, but I don't have any gas. I'm out of gas. My propane tank's empty. Well, that usually means the gas lines don't work, or they couldn't get them to work, or the burners, you know, flame out, or somebody's put in burners that are 900,000 BTU and the flames reach to the top of the trees and there is no adjustment on it. There'll be something crazy. You can count on it. So take your propane tank, take your thing of soapy water, a spray bottle, and that way you turn on the gas lines before you fire it up. You just put, you know, gas to the line, and then you spray the lines down and make sure there's no bubbles. If you see bubbles, turn it off. Turn off your gas at your tank and double check it. Make sure there's no leaks. If there's something, I'm not trying to get you to avoid buying a used. What I'm telling you is check these things because you want to know what you're getting, and you also want to make sure you're doing it safe. And you want to know, okay, well, it's got a gas leak. Well, that I can show him, and he's going to come down on the price. And so it helps you come down on the price. And now you know, okay, I can fix that for 20. Even if I had to replace the whole line, I can fix that for, you know, $40. And so you tell him, okay, you want 22, it's leaking gas, so I can give you 18 for it. And now you've got bargaining room. And so it's just smart. It's a smart way to go about it. You're not taking advantage. You're just making it known that you are aware of these problems. Let's see. Beware the Craigslist ads that say hot dog cart or concession trailer, $5. I'm in the military. I'm being shipped overseas. I've already left, and they don't have a phone number, and they give you an email, and you email them, and they email you. I can tell you this. If you see an ad that sounds too good to be true, it is, period, on Craigslist. There are so many scams on Craigslist, you have to be careful. Here's two good giveaways. Most people selling something on Craigslist will put their phone number, okay? Legitimate sales. Some don't, just because they don't want to be harassed with calls, and I understand that, so they'll put an email. But it won't sound too good to be true. Maybe a good deal, but it won't be, I got two hot dog carts, they're both brand new, and I just, you know, if I could get $10 for them, I'd take it. And they'll tell you it's already packaged. If you do email them, I got this from a lady that actually did this and lost her money, and she was in Orlando. And she found a good deal. She emailed them, and they said, yep, it's already at the shipping location. I'm already out of the country, but as soon as you release funds, I'll just make it ship to you instead. And she bought it, hook, line, and sinker, and never got her money. You'll never get it back. It's gone. There was no cart. There was no nothing, just some fancy pictures. So if it's used, go see it in person, period, period, period. If they tell you that you can't see it because it's already packaged up, tell them to jump in a lake. Search under the business listings on Craigslist as well, because some people don't know where to list it. You know, they go to miscellaneous items. It's not like they have a category for hot dog carts, but you can list, you can look in business listings and in just general for sale and do a search those ways. You may miss something because they misspelled it, or, you know, you may even want to misspell hot dog or put hot dog together, put hot dog cart and put hot dog together as one word, because some people spell it that way and you'll want to be able to find their ad. Now, if you get there and there's one burner on the cart, that's okay. If you're only going to be steaming and it's a one steam table cart, that's perfect. If it's not, then you don't want one burner. Can you upgrade it? Yes. Depending on what the cart's made out of and how it's set up, it may depend on if you can upgrade it. There's also another thing I want to tell you is that some carts out there, new or used, they will make the steam table that it may say, you know, 5 pans, which is perfect for you or whatever it is. But you notice that, or you don't notice till you get it and you go, oh my gosh, the pans are only 2 inches deep, because it's a little bitty cart and they made the burners real close up. So you use the 2 inch deep steam pans instead of the 4 or 6 or 8. And now you've got a cart that, yeah, it's got all the pans, but they're not deep. So you can only put 4 hot dogs in there at one time. And you know, I'm exaggerating a little bit. So you might get 10 instead of 50. And so it's a big deal. And so you want to go, okay, are your steam pans at least 4 inches? 4 inches is common. 6 inches is even better. But usually 6 inches is for direct heat. But on a steam table, the spillage pan will be 6 and the insert will be 4. But there are some manufacturers doing 4-inch steam table spillage pans and then a 2-inch insert, which just won't do it. It shows me that everybody is still on and we have run over time. So I don't think it matters. Can someone post and let me know if they are still hearing me? Everything's good. We're good to go. Just give me a yes or something in the questions. Hearing fine. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate you. Y'all are so kind. Bunch of you. Yes, yeah. Okay, so it looks like we're going to be good there. And so we'll keep on keeping on. Now, I already told you about taking a spray bottle, scams on Craigslist, checking different listing categories. Now, here's another biggie. Title paperwork. A lot of people buy a cart, never use it, and they don't know what they did with the paperwork. Well, you can't apply for a lost title when they've never titled it, and that creates a problem. So make sure you have a title and it matches the VIN on the cart. Now, some states don't care if it's titled. Like Tennessee does not care. It doesn't have to have a tag, so it doesn't matter. You could buy one in Tennessee and work it in Tennessee, drive it on the road in Tennessee without a tag ever and never have an issue ever. But most states want it tagged. And so if you're in one of those most states, you are going to want to make sure if you're buying a used cart that it comes with the title paperwork that matches the cart and that it's open as far as it's a real title. They've signed it like they would a car because it is a vehicle according to federal law. I didn't mention this earlier, but when you're testing your propane, after you've done your soapy water and spray bottle and all that good stuff, make sure that the cart has, a good flame. Like fire it up and see if you can adjust the flame from a low flame to a high flame. Cause some carts, you can spin that dial all you want. It's always going to be the same flame, and that's okay as long as you're prepared and ahead for that. But you don't want to get home and go, well, I need this burner on low and this one on high because I'm going to boil over here. I'm steaming over here and I'm just lukewarming over here. And you don't have any lukewarm settings. All you have is high and off. And so you want to check that. Also, firebox insulation. Many manufacturers make carts and do not insulate the firebox. That's the part that contains the burners. And so the carts get real hot and the coolers get hot and your ice will last you. My very first cart I bought, I could turn on my burners and start cooking. And within two hours, my ice and my cooler at the time, when I first started, I was putting ice in there, not the jugs of frozen, you know, the milk jug deal. It was melting within an hour to 2 hours. It was gone. There was no ice left. And it was because there was no insulation. It just was straight, like, basically it was made so that my whole cart turned into an oven. And so how you check for that, climb under the cart. If it's closed off where you can't see it, maybe take a screwdriver or two and see if they mind if you take the panel off and look to see if it's insulated. Most of them you can tell from the top. And as long as it's insulated between the back wall and the rest of the cart, it should be fine. It's not the end of the world. Don't panic if it's not. I know vendors out there have been vending for years, way longer than me, and don't have an ounce of insulation, and they just plan ahead for it. They bring extra ice packs. They keep them in a separate cooler, and they replace them out as they work. It's not the end of the world. But it does make it nice when you don't have that additional cost and you don't have to worry about the stuff heating up and cooking in your cooler. So those are things to be aware of. Okay. Now, if they have pans with the cart, which they should, no matter what shape they're in, when you fire it up, put water in the pans, even if it's just a little bit, get a water hose and see if it, you know, works, see if it, everything works. And I know this is extra work, but this is an investment, and I'm, you don't have to follow my advice, but it's going to save you money and get it done quicker. Some of these things are variable. So you may find out, yeah, it's got one burner. I'll be able to live with it. I just need to start making money. So it's not like these are deal breakers. I'm just listing all the things that can come up. So we're underneath the cart. Let's check the top, check the cooler area. Once you've fired it up and you've got it running, and see how hot things start getting. If you can't get to it to check for insulation, you can find out real quick by putting pans and water in it and turning it on, firing it up, putting it on high, and see if you can touch the top. Most carts you can't. Even the insulated ones you can't touch right up against the burners, you know, around the top of the cart, because it exhausts there around the pan lids. That's no big deal. But if 8-10 inches back, it's still hotter, and it's going to melt your ketchup bottle and melt your condiment tray, those are things to think about. Okay, well, maybe you'll have to hang that off the side. Maybe you'll have to build a little rack for it. Maybe you'll have to have a side table, whatever. I'm just letting you know the things that to look for. Maybe let it run for 15, 20 minutes and then check the cooler. See how hot it is. It may be scorching hot. As far as it may be, you know, started out at 80 and now it's 110 inside the cooler. And that happens. Make sure the cooler is insulated. There is a manufacturer out there, believe it or not, and it's not one of the ones, you know, you see a lot, but he is a manufacturer. He's been in business longer than me, and he does not put insulation on any of his coolers. His coolers are just basically sinks that you would put, you know, you've seen those garage sinks that you would have in your garage. You know, it's like a big plastic tub, and you just put a faucet in. It's just a big wash tub. He uses those for coolers. They're not insulated. They're just mounted inside the cart with a lid. And that's fine as long as you plan ahead for it. Know that you're going to have to buy 16 cans of spray foam and spray foam it. And you'll have to spray foam all around it and get it insulated good so that it will hold. Even if the burner box isn't heating it up, at least you'll know that it's going to hold up. Now check your water lines, turn on your water, make sure it's working. If it's a gravity flow system, you'll get very fine trickle. You know, it won't no pump a kick on. If it's a pressurized system, you'll hear a pump kick on. Most pumps, most pumps are going to be a switch. You'll have to turn them on. And some manufacturers put a switch right there by the faucet. You turn on the switch, then you turn on your faucet and you got water. And then you turn off the faucet, you turn off the switch. Our carts, they're on demand, which means as soon as you turn on the faucet, the pump comes on, it knows. It's smart. It's like sneaky smart. And anyway, it comes on. Some other manufacturers do that as well. Your higher-end manufacturers, they do that as well. And so you end up not having to do any extra work. You just turn on the faucet like you would at home, and you got water. And that solves the problem. Check the cart to make sure it has a suspension. There are some people that have made their own carts. They look just like a professional cart. They look great, and they used a trailer without any suspension. It's an axle bolted to a frame, literally, and it will beat your teeth out of your mouth going down the road. As far as it isn't worth it. If it doesn't have a suspension, I wouldn't buy it personally, unless I was going to invest in $200 and buy a trailer to haul it on. It doesn't have to have springs and shocks. I'm talking about even leaf springs. If it's got leaf springs, you're fine. See if you can determine the size of your water tank and your freshwater and your wastewater tanks, and make sure that the water goes through them. If you have to hook a hose to it, make sure it works. If something doesn't work or is unable for you to check, don't worry about it. Don't panic and go, it doesn't have the no pressurized water, and it seems to leak here. It's not the end of the world. It's something you can fix if you want to and you're able to, but now you've got a little bargaining chip and you know what you're getting. We talked about suspension. We've talked about the stuff I'm behind in my button clicking. I get to talking and I forget to hit the button. We talked about the size of tanks, and we just talked about fixing it. And now we are going to talk about, does it matter? And now here's the part that I've already touched on. Does it really matter what you pay? Does it matter if you get ripped off? As long as that cart, you know, it can be approved and it's making money. Let's say you overpaid $2,000 for it and you got hoodooed and it didn't really come with a free supply of Hershey's candy bars. And you got home and you just feel bad and, oh my gosh, I spent $2,000 more than I should have for this cart. I got ripped. And you feel like crap. Let me make you feel better. 6 weeks down the road, 12 weeks down the road, 20 weeks down the road, it ain't gonna matter. That cart will have paid for itself several times over. And even though you did pay more for it than you probably should have or could have, it was a means to an end. There are people out there right now, vendors like me, that lease carts for $100 a day or $300 a week or $800 a month. And that means somebody using the cart is going to pay for it at $800 a month. They're going to pay for it every 3 months. But it's a means to an end for some people. If they're making $5,000 a month off of it, $800 a month rent isn't bad. Even $3,000 a month and paying $800 rent. Now they're making more than most people make at full-time jobs. And so don't factor it that way and don't worry yourself over it. If you do make a bad decision, it's not the end of the world. As long as you did the preliminary stuff, like when you find a used cart and you go look at it and you go, okay, which manufacturer is this? And can I get the schematics? If they're a decent, if they're smart, legitimate manufacturer, they'll have their schematics available for you. You can download them from their website or they'll email them to you. Get those schematics, take them to your health department, and get your pre-approval. Make sure, and they may not call it a pre-approval. They may call it a plan review or something. But all you want to do is basically get 2 minutes with them and go, listen, I can't, understand your legalese on all this. So I don't know if this cart's going to work, but I wanted to get your blessing on it just based on what you see. I know you can't give me a definite, but does it look right? Does it have the right number of sinks? Do you see anything that would stop you from what you have here from approving it? And he'll probably, or she'll probably go, no. Or they may go, yeah, it's got 2 sinks. We require 3 here. And you go, okay, I forgot about that. And so now you've got a little more to go on. Let's talk, advertising, looking for a cart. Even if you don't find any carts on Craigslist, if you'll advertise that you're looking for a cart, somebody may pull up. They have wanted ads and it doesn't cost you anything. It's worth doing. New carts, obviously, I'd be an idiot if I didn't tell you, benscarts.com. I'd love it if you plan on buying a new cart that you at least consider us. we used to say that we were the, you know, Chevy compared to the Cadillac. I don't refer us anymore like that, because as we've gotten bigger and better, we've gotten better equipment. We make now what I consider the Cadillac in carts. And so there's very little reason why, or difference. There's a few things that, you know, we don't have the equipment yet to be able to put our name in the front of the cart, you know, etched out into it. That's an expensive piece of equipment that does that. And so we don't do that yet. But things like that will come. But I'd love it if you'd consider us. Our designs are industry leading. And because I work our carts and my partner still works our carts, and I mostly do it charity events and stuff, but I still work a cart. And because we stay on the front lines with other vendors and we talk to a lot of our customers, we understand as far as we make changes as we hear stuff. Now, if somebody says, yeah, you need a bubblegum machine, I'm not probably going to add that. But if 500 people say you need a bubblegum machine on the side of the cart, we'll probably add one. So we've slowly gotten better and better and better. And now I say that we truly provide one of the best carts on the market. Now, all in all, there's some great companies. I've mentioned one to you tonight. That was Dreammakers, excellent company. And they provide great carts. If you ask me, though, if you run across a company and you have questions, call me. I don't mind telling you if there's something I know about them. But you can always do your homework on a cart company. There's so much online that's available to everybody. You can go to the forums and blogs and find out places where we have no control what you write. So, you know, customers can go to a blog and write all kinds of stuff, and that's searchable on Google and Yahoo and Bing. And so do your research and make a good decision. If you do find something negative on a cart company, like I know there's a cart company right now. He's not like a buddy of mine. We don't go fishing together, but he makes a good cart, and he makes a really good cart. And he's got two negative things on the internet because he sent me, you know, links to them, and he wanted, you know if I knew how to get them off, and there's not a way to get them off. They're just on there. But the point is, you know, out of the hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of customers he served, he's got two bad things. And there's always two sides to every story, but from what I know of him, he's a good stand-up guy and backed up what he said. And so you have to take that into consideration, too. It's like, you know, if you want to look up Cadillac, there'll be people that badmouth it, too. And Cadillac's a good company, or Mercedes, or anything you look up, there'll be something negative and positive. So take that into consideration as well. We are going to take another break, a short one, probably another 5 minutes, and then we're going to go into getting all legaled up and doing this right. But first, before we go to the break, I want to do this real quick. If you don't have enough money to buy a cart right now, used or new, there are some other methods. You can run an ad seeking the use or part-time use, or go around and see if you can find a vendor. Vendors don't work for the most part 7 days a week. So there will be days that he's not using a cart or she's not using her cart. And if you can build a rapport with them, you possibly could rent the time to work their cart. I know of vendors that have gone and worked for free, kind of helped out a vendor to kind of get their feet wet. You know, can I work with you on Saturday? You know, do you care? And some vendors wouldn't mind, and they work beside you, help you, or you help them. And all of a sudden now you've got an in, and they go, you know what? On Saturdays, I don't even use this cart. If you want to use it, you're welcome to it. And I know people that have done that and people that do it. I just had a guy yesterday he emailed me and said, do I know of anybody that rented carts, blah, 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 in his town? And I said, no, I don't know of anybody, but check the forums, check the stuff, get on Craigslist. And he found somebody. In a day, he found somebody that would let him use a cart. I assume he didn't write it in the email, but he said, I found a cart that I'm going to be able to rent. But I assume he found a vendor on the side of the road, you know, and who wasn't using their cart part-time. And there's vendors out there like that. And so that may be something to consider if you want to get your feet wet, even if you have the money to buy and you want to get your feet wet first and try, go see if you can work with a vendor. Some vendors aren't going to let you because it's just, it, you know, it can become a headache. You go, oh my gosh, now I got to train this guy. I'm basically training competition is the logic behind it. But either way is some of them won't let you, and don't be offended if they won't. But some of them don't mind. I know vendors out there that do help. We used to keep a list on the blog here. We had to take it off because there was so many that had to that they were got so many calls. And as far as it was just unreal the amount of calls they were getting. One lady out west, I think it was 30-something emails she got in one day after being on the list, people wanting to come run her cart with her. Well, that's just ridiculous at that point. You can't do that. And so it ties up your day. So that's the that's that. And we'll be back in just a few minutes, 5 minutes, let's say, and we'll keep going. I know it's late, and I hope you can hang with me. If not, all this will be available in video, and we'll get you going. Thanks.